Hi all. If you have any questions on SQL MSBI, please write a mail to training2sql@gmail.com. And please subscribe to our channel for more SQL MSBI technology up-to-date videos. In this video, we'll talk about performance improvements in SSRS. So first of all, what are all the places where we can see the performance lags? And so what are all the places we can improve the performance in the SSRS side? See, there are many reasons why my report is going to take a long time. So these are the points. So I have collected based on my experiences. So you might have be seeing a different scenario where you might be seeing a different improvement. So that might be a scenario for you as well. But so based on my experience, so I have collected some points. So where are all the places where we can improve the performance of a particular SSRS reports. So these are all the points I could see to improve the performance of a report. First of all, so before going to check the in-depth, let's try to observe the performance stats. See, my performance stats, how can I see the performance stats? So whenever you deploy a report in a report manager or report server, so that entries are going to be placed in the physical report server database. So that report server is going to contain, so that report name and who are all going to access that particular report. So whenever a user access a report, so it is going to store the statistics of the user and who accesses that particular report, and like what are all the parameters he has passed to access that particular report, and at what time that execution is started, at what time the execution is ended, how much time it took to retrieve the data, how much time to process the data, how much time it took to render the particular data. So these are all the statistics you can see in the report server database of a report server database in the SQL server instance. So let me show you how to see the report statistics or performance statistics in the report server database. If you connect to the SQL Server Management Studio, so there, so you can see my report server instance name is report server, and means my database name is report server, and it automatically comes with the instance name. My instance name is SQL 2012. Similarly, like if your instance name is XYZ, you will be getting here report server dollar that XYZ. So my instance name is this. So that is the reason why. So I'm seeing report server database name with that instance name. So if your instance name is dot, you will not be getting anything. Dot is a default instance. So that time you will be getting only report server. So nothing to worry here. So the database name is report server is common. So after the report server, so you will be getting if you have any instance in your system. Otherwise, so you will get only report server. You won't get $SQL 2012. So that is the reason I am getting SQL 2012. My instance name is SQL 2012. So let's leave that part. Yeah, now, so this is the query. So which will give you the list of statistics. If you see here, so in my report manager, I have many reports which got deployed into the report server and report manager. So I have accessed this particular report 9 times. If you see execution count is happened, means I ran that particular report 9 times. So if you see for all the 9 times, so it took around 804 milliseconds and processing is 168 milliseconds. And the rendering time is 124 milliseconds. So these are all for 9 executions. If you see the next report is for 6 executions. If you see, it is a very basic report. It does not have any so database calls. That's the reason why it does not require. Now, if you go to this next report, so look up. If you see this, so it took around 11,560 milliseconds, and this one is 5,160 milliseconds, and this is 1,984 milliseconds, and so on. If you see, so these are all the reports have been taken respective timings. So here you will be having. So 3 times. So one is the data retrieval time. Next one is the data processing time. The next one is the time rendering time. So based on these statistics, you can decide now. So where exactly my report is taking time? So either data retrieval place or time processing or time rendering. So based on this, you can decide where exactly your report is lagging. So now you can come to this. So once you have a statistics in your hand, so then you can try for the other options based on the place where it is taking long time. Let us see here. The next point is try to use a cached report. So here, so once you, if you enable a cache facility in your report manager, so then the retrieval time is going to save. Then you can save the retrieval time. So means that you can see, once it is enabled, you can see the report in a quicker manner. You can see the report in a very quick manner. So the next option is try to handle the business logics in the processor rather than in the reports. Let us say, so there is a one business logic. Let us say I have a business logic where I can handle in both the places. Let us say in the stored procedure as well as in the report. So in that scenario, let's try to handle that scenario in the procedure only. So because, so you can save the some time rendering time in the report. So let's try to handle all the business logics in the procedures only than writing the expressions in the report design. Next. So let us say I have an employee report. Let us say I have an employee report. So which is going to show you like around 1000 records. So that time, rather than displaying all the 1000 records in a single page, please use the pagination. Please use the pagination. So that time you can save lot rendering time. You can save the lot much rendering time. So if you see 1000 records will coming in one shot, and if you display 50 records in one page, means it will display very quickly manner. So try to use a pagination. So whenever you have a more number of records in a particular report, so that means that rendering time is going to save in a design part, means in the retrieval, means in the report statistics. Next one is less expressions. So there are some scenarios, so where you need to write the expressions in the report design. So please try to keep the less number of expressions. So if you use less expressions, then report rendering time is going to save. You are going to save the report rendering time. So based on the expressions also, based on the report design, if the report design is a complex, then it is going to take rendering time, more rendering time. So again, like while giving you the report performance, you need to sum. So data retrieval time, time processing time, and data rendering, report rendering time as well. So all these mixes gives you the, report statistics. So that's how, so you need to reduce the, means let's try to use a basic design in the report. So rather than using a complex design, if you have a specific requirement to use a complex design, then that's all, that is the option. You cannot do anything. Let's try to use as much as less expressions. Next one is so try to reduce rendering time. So by doing that, like all the stuff, let us say, so let's try to handle the business logic in the processors than in the report design. And next one, so use the pagination if the report contains more number of records. Next, so you try to use reduce the number of expressions in a report design. So by making all this stuff, you can save little so rendering time. So if once you reduce the rendering time, it means that so you are going to get a report in a very performant, means you are going to get the report in a very quicker. So it means, so there are some reports, if the report design is a complex, so that time, so data retrieval may be less than the rendering time. So that time you need to concentrate more on the reducing the rendering time. So these are all the main factors. So you might be like, in your case, you might have faced different scenarios where you can implement some more better stuff. So that might be. So these are all the major points where you need to focus while designing a report. So if the report is a very complex, so then you might be facing a very hard time to reduce the rendering time. But try to convince the people to make a basic design in the front end. So once the report is done, you will be deploying the report manager. So let's run that particular report with a specific data and observe the performance statistics. So before giving it to the client, or you can, based on the performance statistics, you can identify where exactly it is taking time. So based on the statistics, you can decide what are all the steps you can take it further to run that report in a very quicker manner. So these are all the points you need to be aware while developing a report design. So that's it. So please share and subscribe to our videos. Thank you. Thank you for watching.